Good day, fellow investors. I want to really tell a personal story about my investing history because it will show you my mindset, which, as Buffett says, is crucial when it comes to investing. And I don't know whether I have been fortunate or I have had the right mindset when it comes to investing, but I have done really, really well for myself in the past 15 years. So we'll go through my best investments, how it all started, what is my return that I achieved for myself in the past, and what do I expect to do in the future. So let's start by when I started. I started investing in 2003. I remember that my parents had some shares. There was a tender offer. My father and my grandfather sold them. My grandmother was in the hospital. She didn't sell. She came back from the hospital 6 months later. They sold at the second tender for 100% higher price. My 18-year-old mind went, whoa, I could have made 100% in 6 months. So what did I do? I started researching stocks. I went to the list of the complete stocks that we had on the Croatian stock market. It was about 50 stocks. And I read some books. Okay, how does Buffett invest? Just buy good stocks, good companies, good businesses with a low price earnings ratio. And I found two such stocks. One was Tesla. Not the current Tesla, but Ericsson Nikola Tesla. It was Ericsson's subsidiary in Croatia that was a global business building communication technology for mobile systems in countries that Ericsson from Sweden wouldn't go. I don't know, Kazakhstan, Africa, etc. They were extremely profitable and they had a dividend yield of 33%. You heard that right, 33%. So I invested some money in that company, and the other company was a bottling company from Croatia, a very strong brand. I called all the people I knew across the country, also in neighboring countries, and asked them what kind of bottled water do you have in your fridge? And everybody was confirming I have this, this, and this. They were growing about 15% per year. The price to earnings ratio was 6-7, and I put most of my money in that bottling company. So that was 2003. 2006, the bottling company went from 10,000 in 2 years to about 50,000, 60,000 when I sold everything. So I made six times my money. And the Tesla, Ericsson Nikola Tesla stock went from a 33% yield to a 3% yield. So also with the dividend, I made about 10 times my money there. So I sold everything, I think it was 2006, 2007, and I was completely in cash in 2007 with my portfolio being up about 4 or 5 times. So that was one. Then I was a little bit experimenting with part of my portfolio in the US, and I sold everything somewhere in 2008 because I wasn't happy. I lost some money. I think it was a 15-20% loss. Then in 2009, I invested in a tobacco company because it was trading below cash per share, and in another shipping company that didn't do so well. So this company mitigated the loss on the shipping company that I sold very quickly. So we have, actually, I'm still long that shipping company with six shares or something, but I don't even take that into account because that was a split or something and I never sold. I never registered those shares. Who knows what's that word now? Nothing. However, then in 2010, I found another company that was growing 10-15%. It was a hospitality company, 10-15% growth, no debt, 8% dividend yield and price earnings ratio of 6. And there was a highway that was being built from the center of Europe straight to the sea where this hotel company was. So I bought that. I think 70-80% of my portfolio went into this company and another 30-20% went into a company that had a 5% dividend yield. Fast forward 5 years, 2014, 2015, this company continued to grow at 15% a year, making a lot of cash, paying the dividends, and I sold everything in 2015 for, the company was 4 times up, I reinvested a lot of the dividends, so let's say that was a 5-bagger, the 5% dividend stock went up just 50%, which is not bad. So again, from 2010 to 2015, I was up again 4, four times, let's say, on my portfolio, which is something very, very good. And this is where the bulk of my past returns came. From 2015, my biggest investment in 2015 was real estate, on which I expect to cash in the next 6 months. So a lot of money, a lot of the focus went on to the real estate investment because it was the best risk reward investment. I could buy a house with no money down. It was a really bad market here in the Netherlands, but the cost of renting was 50 or 100% above the cost of a mortgage. Not even the not just the interest on the mortgage, the complete mortgage with a 30-year payoff. So I said either house prices are going up to the rent prices or rent prices are going down to the house prices. So, okay, I don't lose anything. Fortunately for me, house prices went up to the rent prices as the market turned from a very pessimistic to a very positive market. But when the deal closes, I'll be happy to make a few videos on that and how I invested in real estate. So without counting the real estate investment, up to 2015, my stocks were up 20 times. Since 2015, I invested a little bit. Nevsun did really good. Amira, I still ended up positive on that because I traded a lot on the fluctuations. So I was still up about 15, 20% over the past few years. But I remember my money is mostly in real estate now until I cash in. And then I'll go for checking out what will I do with that money. So this is what I wanted to present you because it's really about the mindset. And I'm, again, now, I have this Ericsson Nikola Tesla and the bottling company, the tourist company and the real estate. So practically three great in times when I invested. And that's what I'm waiting again. I'm waiting for great businesses, great assets, low risk, no risk of permanent capital loss, great cash flows, great dividends and growth. When I find those stocks, those criteria again, I will again deploy a lot of my money. I was 80, 90%, I think 100% in stocks in 2010, because that was the best time to do that. 2015, I made a lot of money on stocks. Real estate was really cheap, so I really focused my focus on that and to do that properly. I spent 8 months, me and my wife looked at more than 100 properties, really physically, and I would look at 20, 30 properties online. I knew every color of every wall in the 50 kilometer square area that I was looking to buy a house. Similar now I'm doing with stocks, following carefully what to buy, when to buy, and when those stocks hit my 5 criteria, then I'll go in big, because I know that then I'll get my 15, 20%, 25%, 30% yearly return. At this moment in the market, that's very hard to find. And that's something you can see on my stock market platform exposure that is really, really low. We are waiting for opportunities. And I have the feeling those opportunities that I really like will come soon. Let me first sell my real estate so that I can deploy more money to the stock market when the opportunities come. So I wanted to share this because of the mindset that comes. Sometimes it's just better to do nothing or learn about the markets, how things see, because I see a lot of you chasing those returns, chasing those stocks. Oh, this stock is going up and down. No, it's about finding great businesses at the right time. And that's what I do. And that's what I'll keep doing. And that's why you see my exposure being very little now. So that's something to keep in mind, and I urge you to check my stock market research platform, because then you will see what's my stock market exposure, and then you will understand how am I playing this market, how am I investing in this market, or better to say, just looking at the great opportunities, looking at the risks reward, and then investing when the risk is low and the potential return is high. Thank you for watching. Looking forward to your comments. I hope I have given you a good insight into my investment mindset and that it will help you out in time too.